Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. This week I'm going to show you how you can recreate the look of a Polaroid picture. Not actually the picture itself, but the frame that went around it. I'm thinking about the classic kind of Polaroid picture from the 70s, the one that had the little white frame and the big white bit at the bottom. Now the simplest way by far is to go and grab yourself an old Polaroid picture from the family album, photograph it and use it in Photoshop. I haven't got any of those, unfortunately, so I'm going to have to create mine from scratch. Let's see how we do it. Okay, so here's a blank screen, nothing on it at all. So let's start by making file, new. We're going to make a new image. Now I'm going to make mine exact size, 1000 pixels on each side. 1000 pixels, like so. And then we can just click OK. Now that'll make us a nice square image. But it's white. I don't actually want it to be white. I want it to be black. So let's go for Control and I, or Command I on a Mac, to invert the colour to black. Now the next bit's quite important. We're going to add a frame in and we need to choose the colour for the frame. Now I want mine to be white, so I'm going to make my background colour white by either hitting D on the keyboard or clicking the small black and white button there. Now come up to Image, choose Canvas Size, and we were working in pixels before, so let's stick to pixels. And you can see I've got 1,000 pixels for width and height, but I'm going to change mine now to 1,100. Now this will increase my canvas size, my image, by 100 pixels all the way around, so 50 pixels each side. And I get this nice little white frame. But the kind of Polaroid image I want to recreate had a big thick bit at the bottom. So we're going to add that in by going back to Image, Canvas Size, and using pixels once more, but this time making the height 1300 pixels. Now it's important that you anchor this in the top center, just there, and click OK. Okay, so that's given us the look of a Polaroid frame, but it doesn't quite look convincing. It needs a bit more work doing to it. Look at the layers first of all. We need to get rid of this padlock because I need to do some work and I can't do it on a background layer. So double click the background layer, change the name to anything, and the padlock disappears. Grab yourself the magic wand tool, click on the black area, hit delete on the keyboard, and that'll delete that black area from the picture. Select, deselect. Now we've got this white frame with nothing in the center, but really want to make this look a little bit more real. We want to put a bit of depth in here and a bit of texture here as well. And we're going to do that by using a layer style. Layer style, choose bevel and emboss. Now this will add a bit of thickness to the image, but I'm going to soften the whole effect down. So it's just the standard default settings, but I'm going to push the softness up just so it blends it out like that. Next, I'm going to come down to Pattern Overlay. We'll click that, and it'll apply a pattern to the white parts of the picture. It's not really the pattern I wanted, if I'm honest with you there. That one's pretty hideous. Instead, we're going to load in our own new pattern by clicking the little down arrow right next to the pattern. It's pretty small. You've got to watch out for it, but there it is. You can see I've only got two patterns to choose from. God, that's dull, isn't it? Let's add some more in by clicking the arrow in the top right corner. There's lots down the bottom to choose from, but I'm going to go with coloured paper. Choose the Append option and scroll down your list of new textures. And it's the third one from the end, this one right here, which is the white textured paper. Click that, and that gives you a much more kind of papery look. Let's click OK. If I zoom in, hopefully you might be able to pick up there is a kind of a papery texture there. But it's not quite what I want to do. I want to darken that texture down. I can't do that directly on the images is here. So I'm going to get rid of these effects by making a new empty layer and going back to layer and merging visible. And that'll merge the empty layer with the frame that we made and all the effects will merge in as well. So that's a nice quick way of getting rid of those. Now up to Image, choose Adjustment and Levels, because I don't want a pure white edge to it. I'm going to move the mid-grey slider in a little bit until I get a sort of greyish colour. Not too grey, just grey enough, just so it makes it stand away from a white background. Because ultimately, that's what this picture is going to end up on. I'm going to make a little montage of these Polaroid squares, and they're all going to end up on a white background. Now, at this stage, you might want to save this picture, because this is done. It really could be saved and used as a template for the future. Once you've done that, come up to Select, Select All, and then Edit and Copy. And then we need a picture to put this on, so I've got one here. Because I kind of remember the Polaroid pictures as being something from my youth, in the sort of 70s. I've got a nice kind of 70s picture here, taken recently at a 70s birthday party. Everybody was dressed up in fancy dress. It was a fantastic evening. And I thought this image would work well with my retro Polaroid frame. Okay, let's go up to edit and paste it in. And there's my frame. Now you could see it's quite small on here. If I'd have made my image 2,000 pixels at the start, it would have been a lot bigger. But I've done this on purpose because I want several of these Polaroid frames. I want this to look like it's lots of small Polaroid pictures just chucked on the floor to make a main picture. Right, let's get ourselves the free transform, edit, free transform, and we'll move this off to the side and rotate it around. I could have used Control T, and in fact, in future for this tutorial, that's exactly what I'm going to use. And I now need to make a copy of this frame, because I need a few of these. So we'll go for Layer, Duplicate Layer. Now again, I could have used Control J, which is what I will use in future from now. Okay, so Control T will bring up Free Transform, and we'll just move this across and give it a bit of a twist. They ought to be slightly different angles. I'm going to get these two guys here very much into the whole kind of groove there. And we'll click the tick. And Control and J, or Command J on a Mac, of course. And then Control T, or if you're a Mac user, that's Command T. And you can then position these in. Now, you could do as many of these as you like. I'm just going to do a few, because it's going to take, obviously, a few minutes to do this. I think we'll do maybe one or two more. Okay, let's bring that along, and let's put one down here somewhere. Like that, and then we'll copy that with Control J, free transform it with Control T. You can see that using the keyboard shortcuts, you can really speed along. Something that's reasonably complex can actually just take a few seconds to do. Right, okay, so I've now got 5 frames. I think that's enough for this technique, but you can add in more if you wish. But I've also got the whole of the picture. It just doesn't quite work. We've got to put a little bit of the picture just inside of the frame and no more. To do that, we're going to come back down to the background layer, click it to make it active, then go to Select, Select All, Edit, Copy, and dump the selection. We don't need that anymore. We also don't need the whole background layer. We can get rid of that as well. So Edit and Fill. I'm going to fill it with, let's choose white from that drop-down list. There we go. Right, so that's filled it with white. Lovely. And, well, I can't see the picture anymore. Well, let's see what we can do about that. Let's click on the top layer. The top layer is this frame right down there in the bottom corner. I'm going to get my magic wand tool and click inside of that frame. And that makes a selection. Now I can go up to Edit and choose Paste Into, and it'll paste it into the selection. But not the whole picture, you note, just a small part. Have a look at the layer. There is our whole picture pasted in. Next to it, there's a layer mask, and on that layer mask is a white square that represents where we had our selection. Okay, drop down a couple of layers and find another square, another frame. Use the magic wand again and edit, paste into again. And it pastes another bit of the image. So by pasting into, I can put a little bit of the picture in each one of these frames. So let's come down a couple of layers again. And with the magic wand, let's find out which layer it is. I can never remember, so switching the layer on and off is really useful. And paste into. Don't use ordinary paste, by the way, that just won't work. And this one should be there, that's it. Edit, paste into. And finally, let's find the last one. I know it's obviously got to be this one. And edit and paste into. And it works really well, so you can't see through the frames anymore, and it all fits neatly in. So this does look like a nice little pile of pictures. But if you want to make this look a little bit better, a couple of things you could do. First of all, you could put a little bit of drop shadow in behind each of these frames. Let's have a look at that. So let's start up here on the top, but not actually the top layer, the top frame. Okay, really important that, the top frame. Then I'm going to go up to Layer, Layer Style, and choose Drop Shadow. I'm just going to increase the size of this just so it kind of blends it out, and I'm just going to drag it down so we get that kind of drop shadow like that. Click OK. That puts the drop shadow in. It gives you this little FX icon. I've got to repeat that for the other 4 frames, but instead of trying to do that slowly, I'm actually just going to hold the Alt key and drag and drop it on. Okay, that's the Option key on a Mac, but whichever you're using, Mac or PC, hold Alt, drag and drop, and you can put those on the frames. Again, not on the pictures, only on the frames. And that just lifts it up slightly. So that's kind of nice. Another thing you can do is just break up the effect here. For example, if I want to move these chaps here, you see the shoulder line goes neatly through from one picture to another. But I don't want it to be that symmetrical. So I'm going to find the layer they're on, which must be this one. And I'm going to click it, and I'm going to move my mouse to the gap between the image and the layer mask. And click once, and that'll put that little link icon back in that was missing before. Now hold the shift and click the layer directly below. So now I've got these two layers selected. And if I get myself the move tool, I can simply move that around. It'll move not only the image, but the layer mask and the frame all together. And I can just put that so it's just a little out of register. And if I really want to, I can also move the order of this as well, because you can see this guy's face is kind of covered by this frame. So if I drag this up a little bit, let's find out where we are. There we are. And I'm just going to drag that up a little higher, put it there. You see, I lift him over the layer below, and now that Polaroid picture looks like it's actually above the others. So you can play around with the whole style and the whole effect and get exactly the look you're going for. Okay, so there we are. There's how you can create a montage of old-fashioned Polaroid pictures and create some really exciting looking pictures.